The goal for this video is to give you all the basics that are required to do web development, no matter which language or platform you are working with. By the end of it, you will know the various components of every web application and also the various terminology or technologies that make up a web application. To start with, every web application, if you have accessed your Gmail or Facebook or any other website on the internet, you have already accessed a web application or you have used a web application. Every web application can be accessed from a browser, unlike the earlier applications where you need to install a client application on your desktop to access a server-side application. Web applications can be accessed from a web browser. Examples of web browsers are, right now, whatever you are using, Chrome, Firefox, Internet Explorer, Safari, etc. A web browser understands HTML. So HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. As the name itself says, it's hyper and it's also a markup language. It has two things. Hyper because it can jump from one page to another. That's the way it links the entire web. When you go to a website, either you click on a button or you click on a link and you go to another page. Correct? So that's all done using HTML. Secondly, markup language. It's markup because when you use HTML tags around some text or any data, they add some special meaning. When the browser displays them, it displays them beautifully, right? So that's HTML. So a browser understands HTML and also it can understand JavaScript. JavaScript allows you to do some browser-side programming and browser-side validations. That's where it all started. JavaScript was usually initially used for doing some client-side validations. If he enters a wrong email ID, if he doesn't enter a mandatory field, and all those validations we were doing on the client side using JavaScript. But as the web evolved with the introduction of AJAX, which stands for asynchronous Java calls using XML, asynchronous JavaScript calls using XML, the JavaScript has been being used since the introduction of AJAX. JavaScript became even more powerful to develop client-rich or browser-rich applications using asynchronous callbacks to the server. And then came JSON format. Instead of getting XML back, which is hard to parse and all that, to build the UIs, JSON is a very lightweight data format which can be sent from the server applications to the browser and which can be easily consumed by the client applications. So usually our web applications are made up of these technologies here. Along with all the static content, we have CSS, which stands for Cascading Style Sheet. It adds special formatting to our HTML pages to make them look even more beautiful. And then SSP is a shortcut for server side program. Since all these guys, most of them are static, we need a server side program that can pull the data from the database and hand it over back to the browser. So if we are developing a static web application which doesn't deal with the database, which is very rare today, we only need HTML, JavaScript, etc. But if you are doing any dynamic stuff to retrieve data from a database or content management system like SQL Server, Microsoft SQL Server, Oracle MySQL, etc., you need a server-side program. In Java, the server-side program could be a servlet, a Spring MVC-based UI, which is calling into the DAO layer. In .NET, it could be an ASP page, a web service, etc. At the end of it, what goes to the browser is HTML and JavaScript. That is the key that you should remember. I'll be going into each of these topics in depth in the future. I'll explain them in detail. But the request comes from the browser to a server. The server, if it's a static content like HTML, it directly serves them back to the browser. If it has to fetch something from the database, if we write our application to be a dynamic web application, then it will run the corresponding server-side program, which could be a servlet, a JSP page, an ASP page for .NET developers, a Python script, whatever, and then get the data back. And then our scripts will take the data, put it in HTML format, send it back to the browser. So that's what any web application is made up of. So to summarize it, you now know what a web application is, the key technologies that are used today to come up with any dynamic web application. In a future session, you will learn about each one of these in detail. At a high level, you have learned HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. You now know why it is called Hypertext Markup Language. JavaScript, usually used for validations, but starting the introduction of Ajax made it even more powerful. We can call back dynamically from the browser to the client, to the server side, get a JSON response and build UIs on the fly. And also Ajax brings in a lot more frameworks like Knockout.js, jQuery, etc., which make our job as a developer easy. Instead of writing a lot of code, we'll be using these APIs to do Ajax, etc. CSS stands for Cascading Style Sheet. It adds special formatting and look makes our UIs even more easier, even more better. And we can use the same CSS across the application, across various pages in the application. SSP is a shortcut for server-side program. That's the program, Java.NET program, which runs on the server, which connects to the database, has all the business logic, brings the data back, and it finally, at the end of it, it converts the data into HTML, sends it back to the browser. If it's simple static data, it's a web server. If it is dynamic data, if we have to run servlets, JSPs, etc., we usually have something called an application server. In the future session, you'll be seeing each of these in action. Until then, take care.